Good morning, students. I am Mrs. Kavita Modi. Today we are going to continue Chapter 7, Multiplication and Division of Decimal Numbers. This chapter, our topic is multiplication of one decimal number by another decimal number. Our next topic is multiplication of one decimal number by another decimal number. Let's take one example. If 1135 multiplied by 72 is equal to 81720, find the value of question number A. 113.5 multiplied by 7.2. If we ignore the decimal point, the product remains the same. That is 81720. Now count the digits after decimal in 113.5 multiply 7.2. One digit in 113.5 and one digit in 7.2. So the total digits after decimal is 2. So count two digits from the right, 1, 2, and place decimal in the product. So the answer is 817.20. That is 817.2. Let us solve one more example. If 1135 multiplied by 72 is equal to 81720, find the value of 1.135 multiplied by 7.2. If we ignore the decimal point, the product remains the same. That is 81720. Now count the digits after decimal in 1.135 multiplied by 7.2. Three digits in 1.135 and one digit in 7.2. So the total digits after decimal is 4. So count four digits from the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, and place decimal in the product. So the answer is 8.1720. That is 8.172. Let us solve one more example. If 1135 multiplied by 72 is equal to 81720, find the value of 1.135 multiplied by 0.72. If we ignore the decimal point, the product remains the same. That is 81720. Now count the digit after decimal in 1.135 multiplied by 0.72. Three digits in 1.135 and two digits in 0.72. So the total digits after decimal is 5. So count five digits from the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and place decimal in the product. So the answer is 0.81720. That is 0.8172. One thing I want to mention before we start is that multiplication of decimal number will be much easier for you if you memorize the basic multiplication facts and then be sure to have a multiplication table handy when you are doing multiplication. One more thing you need to remember with multiplication of decimal number is that the order of the problem does not matter, but it is always best to put the bigger number on the top and the smaller number on the bottom. Okay. Let's start. 3.4 multiply 23.6. In this question, first we write the bigger number 23.6 on the top and the smaller number 3.4 on the bottom. Then we draw a carry-on box. And now we will draw a line so our answer can go below it. And we put a multiplication symbol to the left. As usual, we start multiplication from the right. 4 multiply by 6. 4 6 is 24. So 4 we will write below the line and carry 2 to the 1's place. Then 4 multiply by 3. 4 3's are 12. And 12 plus 2, 14. So 4 we will write below the line and carry 1 to the 10's place. Then 4 multiply by 2. 4 2's are 8. And 8 plus 1, 9. So write 9 below the line. There are some things that are very important to do when we start the second digit multiplication. because the second digit of bottom number is in the tens place. So the answer we get should be 10 times bigger. So before we start multiplication, we need to put a zero in the ones place of our answer line. So it's 10 times bigger. Let's start second digit multiplication. Remember, we need to cross out all the digit that carried from our first answer because we have already used them. We do not want to accidentally add them to our second digit multiplication. 3 multiplied by 6. 3 6 jar 18. So write 8 below the line and carry 1 to the ones place. Then 3 multiplied by 3. 3 3 jar 9 and 9 plus 1 10. So write 0 below the line and carry 1 to the tens place. Then 3 multiplied by 2. 3 2s are 6 and 6 plus 1, 7. So write 7 below the line. So the final answer is add these two answers together. So leave one line and just draw a line below them and write a plus sign on the left side. Now we can add them column by column. As usual, we start addition from the right. 4 plus 0 is equal to 4. So write 4 below the line. 4 plus 8 is equal to 12. So write 2 below the line and carry 1. Then add 9 plus 0 plus 1 is equal to 10. So write 0 below the line and carry 1. Then add 7 plus 1 is equal to 8. So write 8 below the line. So the answer is 8024. Now put the decimal. How? Let's see. Just count up how many numbers are after the decimal in both numbers. You are multiplying. 23.6 has one digit after decimal and 3.4 also has one digit after decimal. So the total digit after decimal is 2. So count two digits from the right. 1, 2. Let us solve one more question. 3.1 multiplied by 0.04. In this question, first we write the bigger number 3.1 on the top and the smaller number 0.04 on the bottom. Then we draw a carry-on box. And now we will draw a line so our answer can go below it. And we put a multiplication symbol to the left. As usual, we start multiplication from the right. First, multiply the numbers ignoring the decimal point. 4 multiplied by 1. 4 ones are 4. So write 4 below the line. Then 4 multiplied by 3. 4 threes are 12. So write 12 below the line. So the answer is 124. We know that any digit multiplied by 0, the answer is always 0. Now put the decimal. How? Let's see. Just count up how many numbers are after decimal point in both numbers you are multiplying. 3.1 has one digit after decimal and 0.04 has two digits after decimal. So the total digit after decimal is 3. So count 3 digits from the right. 1, 2, 3. And place decimal in the product. So the answer is 0.124. I hope you all understand multiplication of one decimal number by another decimal number. So complete lesson 7, worksheet 2, once in Maths CW. Thank you. Have a beautiful day.